The most deft of all Cormorite transports is the Venom. This arrow-swift skimmer carries an elite cadre of warriors onto the battlefield. In this video, we're going to show how to paint one of these models. We're going to paint it in the classic method and up to battle ready. But before we do that, we'll need to undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've undercoated it with Mechanica Standard Grey, which is perfect for all the colours we're going to be applying. Now we're going to start with the armour or the hull of the vessel. And for this, we'll be using Lupercal Green. So I'm going to be using a large base brush for this. All I'm going to do is apply a little bit to the palette, like so. And add a little bit of water, just so it's nice and thin and not too thick and goopy. There we are. And all we're going to do then is start applying that action onto the hull. Now, when doing the base coats early on, don't have to be too neat about it because you'll probably get some other colours on other areas. Don't worry because you can always tidy those back up later on. And it's worth doing two thin coats on here as well. There we are with that base coat now applied to the hull. We're going to move on to applying some more base coats. Now we're going to start by using Corvus Black for the bodysuit of the crew member. After that, we're going to be using Balthazar Gold for any brass details and then Ironhand Steel for any silver details. But first of all, let's start with the Corvus Black. So what I'm going to be doing here is using a small layer brush for this because it's kind of small detail on the crew member. So just a touch of water as well, just so it's not too thick and goopy. Get our brush to a nice point, then we're ready to start picking that detail out. So the reason why I'm picking the bodysuit now is because it's quite a fiddly little detail. It's better to do it early on in case you make any big mistakes and splodges. You can just tidy those back up with Lupercal Green. With the Corvus Black now applied and dry, we're going to move on to using Balthazar Gold. Now this is going to be for all the brass details. Now they're all scattered across the model in different places, so if you're not sure, just check the box art for details. With those brass details now done, we're going to use Ironhand Steel for any silver details. There we are with the silver details now done. We're going to move on to applying the rest of the base coats. Now for this, we're going to start with Rakar Flesh. This is going to be used for both the bone and the skin. After that, I'll be using Mephiston Red for any red details. Following that, we'll use Korax White for the greeny glow effects. But first of all, let's start with Rakar Flesh. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette again, a little touch of water, and ready to start picking it out. I'll just start with the skulls first, but don't forget to obviously do the faces and the skin of the crew. And for this, you might want to do a couple of thin coats. With the skin and bone now done, we're going to use Mephiston Red to pick out his hair and any buttons on the dashboard. With the hair now done, we're going to move on to using Korax White. This is to prepare ourselves ready for the green glow. So we're going to get a Korax White base coat on first, then apply Hexo Flame later on. There we are with those details now picked out with Korax White. We're going to move on to the next stage, which is to apply some shades. Now we're going to start with Norn Oil. Now this is going to be for the green areas, the silver areas and the black details. Now for the silver areas and the black details, we're just going to do an all over shade. But for the green armour, especially on the hull, we're going to do a recess shade. So first of all, I'm going to start with that. So I'm going to be using a small layer brush for this and apply a little bit to my palette, get my brush to a nice point. Then all we're going to do is just really carefully start applying that into those fine recesses. Now if you do splodge a bit onto the main panels, you can either just wipe with your finger or just re-tidy back up with Lupercal Green. Once you've done that, just wash all over the black and the silver details. There we are with the Norn Oil now applied. We're going to move on to applying the rest of the shades. Now we're going to start by using Agrax Earthshade. This is going to be for the bronze details, the red and the bone. After that, we'll be using Rykan Flesh Shade just for the skin. And then to follow up after that, we'll be using Hexray Flame for the greeny glow. But first of all, let's start with Agrax Earthshade. I'll be using a medium layer brush here just because it's nice and small and get a good point to it as well. Once I've got a nice point, ready to start applying that. So like I say, we'll start with the brass details, then just pick out some other areas after that. With the Agrax Earthshade now applied and dry, we're going to move on to using Rykan Flesh Shade, and this is just going to be for the skin. And finally, we're going to use Hexray Flame to make the greeny glow effect. So we'll be applying this straight over the Korax White, which will give it a nice greeny kind of eerie glow. And there we are with those shades now dry, our Venom is battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And also when using shades, try not to overload your brush too much, especially when doing those recess shades, as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. And should you make any mistakes, remember you can always tidy back up with those base paints. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own battle-ready Drukhari Venom. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.